Good morning, everyone. So for some announcement, enrollment is now open for school year 2021-2022. Issuance of cards for elementary department is on May 27 from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. Once again, good morning, everyone. Today marks as one of the most special events, not only for our students, but also to our proud and supportive parents. Before we formally start our program, I would like to have some important reminders. Kindly remove your virtual background. It may affect your video quality. Participants are requested to sit properly. Stand straight when singing the national anthem. Always open the camera and raise your hand once you are called so that we can easily identify to pin you. Find a conducive place where there will be no distractions. Make sure there are no open apps or open files on your device. Internet connectivity is the key. Best not to have other devices sharing the bandwidth and running at the same time during the program. Participants are automatically muted. Keep your video on during the program, for the host will record your attendance and will put you on spotlight when the name of the student is called. Comments are encouraged to let us know that you are with us. However, please make your comments be encouraging and uplifting. The program will be recorded. Proper decorum is advised. Once again, good morning and welcome to the Recognition Day program of the Taytay United Methodist Christian School Elementary Department. And now, I would like to present to you the awardees, parents, administrators, pastors, guests, and speakers, followed by the Philippine National Anthem and the opening prayer to be led by Shaila Catrice G. Bandong from 5 Genesis. Thank you.
Dear Lord and Heavenly Father, we come to you this day giving thanks and praise for everything that you have done. You have brought us through a very different kind of school year, staying home and being safe. Thank you, Lord, for keeping us healthy and able to learn all of our lessons in the midst of this pandemic, even in the comfort of our own homes. Thank you, Lord, for the knowledge that we have learned through our teachers. May you bless every single one of them. The job that they are doing is not easy, so Lord, may you grant them even more wisdom, patience, understanding that they need to nourish our young minds. And Lord, may they feel and know that we all appreciate all of their efforts in educating us. Thank you, Lord, for every single student who is here today as we recognize our accomplishments. May we be quick to recognize and remember that all of this, all of the glory, honor, and praise belongs to you alone. Dear Lord, we wouldn't have been able to do any of this without you. And Lord, please keep us in the glory of your grace and the warmth of your love. And Lord Jesus, thank you for all of the blessings, for all of the many blessings that we cannot count or we cannot see. And Lord, the privilege that we have today to virtually gather as we recognize our accomplishments. Lord, we lift our hearts and lives to you, and we ask for your mercy and grace. In your mighty name we pray, amen.
Welcome remarks of one of our awardees, Sophia Agata S. Pascua from For Agape.
To our guest of honor and speaker, Dr. Diane Soliman, our chairperson, Dr. Remedios T. Habacon, our president, Mrs. Girly De Leon, our beloved principal, Mrs. May Geraldine S. Ocampo, dear teachers, our beloved parents, fellow students, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Welcome to one of our most awaited events, the Recognition Day. Thank you for being here with us today to witness the fulfillment of what seemed to be an impossible undertaking at the beginning, the completion of a very difficult school year, and now receiving the fruits of our success and everyone's hard work. God has been gracious to us and held us strongly in his loving and protective arms up to this very moment. Without him, we're nothing, but with him, we can accomplish anything. My heart is full of happiness and gratitude seeing you all today virtually and sharing with you the success of a very challenging online schooling, because I know that it wasn't easy. We all did our part to survive and overcome the learning obstacles because of this pandemic. Whatever merits and awards we will receive today, let us humbly offer to God, who is the source of everything, and to our dear parents and teachers who went above and beyond their capacities and stretched the limits of their patience and strengths just so we can continue with our education despite the challenges of this new normal way of learning. They have been good partners since the beginning, and we would not have done it without them. Fellow students, kudos to us for accepting the challenges of online schooling and enduring all the hardships that went with it. Now is the time to humbly receive our rewards for a job well done. As good stewards of God's gifts, let us continue to be the light and salt of the world, glorifying his name in everything we do, even in our studies. I hope you will all enjoy the whole program virtually and be one with us in celebrating as we receive the fruits of our success and hard work. Your virtual presence is highly appreciated. We may be physically distant, but you are all very close to our hearts. Thank you, and again, my warmest welcome to everyone. Congratulations to all.
Thank you, Sophia, for that wonderful opening remarks. Now it is our time to listen. May I call on Mrs. Betsaida Luz E. Aguilar, the Elementary Academic Coordinator, to introduce our speaker this morning.
Good morning to everyone. It is with deep joy and pride that I undertake the task of introducing our guest speaker this morning. As one of my former students, she has always been very responsible and diligent, traits that she and her siblings, who are also alumni of our school, possess and which we, their teachers, often admire about. Our speaker could often be found in the school library, finishing her school tasks and making sure that all her requirements were in order, ready for submission. As such, it was no surprise when she graduated third honorable mention of the elementary batch 1995, as well as graduating fourth honorable mention of the high school batch 2007. She then went on to obtain her degree of Bachelor in Science in Public Health from the University of the Philippines, Manila in 2011. Graduate studies were next at the Ateneo de Manila University, from where she received her Doctor of Medicine, Master in Business Administration degree in 2016. Our speaker also finished a Master in Public Management, Major in Health Systems degree from the Development Academy of the Philippines in 2018. Her work experience includes serving as rural health physician of the Department of Health from 2016 to 2018. Currently, she is a medical officer, level 3, at the Amang Rodriguez Memorial Medical Center, a position she has held since 2019. My dear awardees, parents, guardians, my fellow teachers, beloved Principal May, guests, ladies and gentlemen, please make welcome our guest speaker, Dr. Dayan Joy C. Soliman.
To Mrs. May Geraldine S. Ocampo, Principal of the UMCS Elementary Department, faculty and staff, students, parents, guardians and guests, good morning. First, let me congratulate you students for having successfully finished another year in school. I also commend the faculty and staff for continuously being good stewards of education despite all the challenges this pandemic caused. And to the parents and guardians, for students, I am celebrating with you. Before I begin, let me read a verse from Matthew 5, verses 13 to 16. You are the salt of the earth, but if the salt loses its saltiness, how can it be made salty again? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. In this verse, salt and light are two natural things used to describe a follower of Christ. Salt is a compound that is used for flavoring and preserving food. It has many purposes. One of the most important is that it helps us to see. For the plants, they use light to produce its food and grow. So what do salt and light have in common? Both salt and light have properties which affect the things around them. In the same way, we as believers and followers of Christ are called to do the same. Like salt, we are to influence the people by showing them the unconditional love of Christ through good deeds. And like light, we are to be witnesses to others concerning the truth of God's word, especially about Christ's resurrection and the hope that we share that God has redeemed us for himself. I want to share 3 points on being salt and light of the world. First, being salt and light of the world is not about who we are. It is about who God is. Let me tell you a short story about myself. Long before passing the board exam and getting my license as a physician, I have always wanted to serve in the rural areas as a doctor to the barrio. Indeed, that's what I did. While my colleagues chose to train as residents and be specialists, I chose the path less traveled. For 2 years, I served as the only doctor in a municipality of 25,000. I left the comforts of the city and lived in the province. The task beforehand was large and daunting. I often held clinics in the barangay that sometimes required me a 30-minute ride of habal-habal, sometimes traverse muddy pathways, and sometimes cross the sea just to reach my patient. There were times of frustration since the best care that I would want to give the patients was hindered by the lack of infrastructure, medicines, and even healthcare workers. I can clearly remember how a 74-year-old man thanked me after his consultation, because in all his years of existence, it was the first time that he was seen by a doctor. Small moments like that made me believe that I am on the right path. People would ask me why I chose to be a doctor in the rural area when I could pursue my career in a bigger hospital. I could only think of one reason, and that is God's unconditional love for me. My deeds and actions to these people were not because of me. It is because of God's overflowing love, so full that I had to share it with others. Again, being the light of the world is not about who we are. It is about who God is. Second, by remaining focused on Christ and being obedient to Him, can we remain salt and light in the world. This stems from a deeper relationship with Him. When you go out into the world, there will be patience and difficulties. We then should be equipped with God's promises and grace. And the Bible shows us God's character and provides a revelation of Himself to the people. Aside from my clinical work as a doctor in the barrio, I was assigned as a municipal health officer, requiring me to do administrative work as well. Among the numerous tasks I was expected to do were to implement health programs, launch health funds, and oversee the welfare of those people working under me, like nurses, midwives, and barangay health workers. There were times when my honesty and integrity were put to the test, but I am reminded to be in swore that whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. What you have learned and received and heard and seen, practice things, and the God of peace will be with you. His word directs us, and it gives us the strength to overcome temptations. Also, His word enables us to be conquerors of the hardships in life. I am currently training as a third-year resident in internal medicine in a tertiary hospital. Since the pandemic started, our task has been more challenging. We are fighting a disease with still no proven cure. As our health system gets overwhelmed, so are nurses and doctors too. There are days when you get to send home patients well, and there are days when you had to break the baggage to a family that your loved one didn't make it. I myself had COVID last year as I am highly exposed to COVID patients. Fortunately, I only had mild manifestations of the disease. After that, I persevered despite the trial, despite the frustrations, because I hold on to God's promise that we are conquerors in Him, as He said in Romans 8, verse 37. In times of trial, we persevere. In times of chaos, we bring peace. In times of indifference, we show more kindness. In times of hate, we love more. All of this we can do only if we are in Christ and we abide in His word. By remaining focused on Christ and being obedient to Him, can we expect to remain salt and light in the world. Third, by fulfilling our calling as light and salt of the world, we direct others toward Him. On verse 16, it is stated that in the same way, let your light shine for others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. I have known God because someone fulfilled their calling as salt and light of the world. It is not one only person, but there were people who lived in God's words and has shown me kindness and love. And through them, God's love to me was revealed. In the same way, I hope that's how I live my life, to be a testimony of God's love towards others and will cause their sympathy with Him. As I end, I challenge you students to be salt and light of the world. Right now, you may still be in school and working for your dream, but every day is an opportunity to be salt and light. In your school, in your home, in the street, always choose love, mercy, kindness. Pray and read the Bible, both lead to the completeness and equipping for every good work. Reflect God's holy, changing, faithful, gracious, and loving character in everything that you think of, speak of, and do. Be a living testament of His love to others. Again, we as believers and followers of Christ, we are to be salt and light of the world. Congratulations, and thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Diane Joy Suleiman, for your empowering words. May your message motivate these young people and be successful as what you are now. For our special song number, let me call on Julianne Rihanna P. Santana from Three Nile.
Of the water, oh yes, I can remember ever living knowing why. I wish I could be a perfect daughter, but I come back to the water no matter how hard I try. Every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know where I can't go, where I long to be. See the land where the sky meets the sea, it calls me, and no one knows how far it goes. If the wind in my sail, me, and one day I'll know. If I could just hang off how I know everybody on this island seems so happy on this island. Everything is by design. I know everybody on this island has someone on this island, so maybe I can roll with mine. I believe in pride, I remain a strong, every side I follow, but the voice inside, she sings a different song. What is wrong with me? See the light as it shines on the sea, it's blinding, but no one knows how deep it goes, and it seems like it's calling me. Beyond that line, well, across that line, see the line where the sky meets the sea, it's calls me, and no one knows how deep it goes. If the wind in myself on the sea stays behind me, one day I'll know how far I go.
Thank you, Rihanna, for that very nice song number. Let us come to the most exciting and most awaited part of the program, the presentation of awards with honors and high honors. Parents are requested to put on the medals of their child when called. Let's start with the grade 1 level with honors. Sophia Edria S. Adan. Sophia Elise S. Adan. John Caden Bernales. Troy Ali M. Buluran. Margo Isabel C. Calderon. Riona Sandra A. Ensigne. Daniel S. Galima. Andrika L. Lagby. Zach Liam L. Maniego. John Riley A. Moralita. Dylan S. Reyes. Johanna Riley Reyes. Kian Kevin E. Rivera. Sean Andre R. Salazar. Dana Beatriz C. Samosa. Gabriel Alan B. Timbal. Jay and Rain C. Valle. Davion Kyle M. Virai. Janine Samia L. Yako. Let us proceed with grade 2 with honors. Kezia Abzi D. Aguilar. Alan Paul M. Aguilion. Gian Ayin A. Almazan. Benaya B. Arevalo. Merston Aidan V. Bautista. Alaria Gabriel V. Burgos. Elijah C. Camargo. Elisha Jane and Dalde. Charleston Louis L. De La Cruz. Prince Ernest Isaac L. De Leon. Wilson C. Desiderio Jr. Marcus Riley A. Bison. Okay, na. Emmanuel Caleb B. Domingo. C.N. Terrence A. Empleo. Kervin Cloud R. Leonardo. Zia Pauline C. Leonardo. Ethan James V. Libang. Christian Paul M. Marasigan. Yanni M. Napolis. Regile O. Perpenia. Maria Savrin O. Reyes. Bea Isaiah Earlis A. Isogabo. Aaron Hezekiah M. Toreja. Kendra Dion N. Talosi. Let us now proceed to grade 3 with honors. Jan Andre L. A. Almazan. Luis Janelle S. Alonso. Leila Martina A. Caballero. Stephen Clyde L. Cruz. Gabriel S. Latunero. Alfonso A. Lodet. James Carlos P. Lim. Christine Ann S. Lising. Alexa Ray B. Medina. Thea Jane Molina. Juliana Candice C. Patricio. Loving Joy C. Simonero. Julian Rihanna P. Santa Ana. Altalia S. Tagulao. Okay. Let us proceed with grade 4 with honors. John Cedric D. Ala. Nicole Gwen B. Balana. Alia Jamel E. Barela. Matthew Jeremy N. Costales. Gilbert S. Dorian. Elijah Samuel D. Leonardo. Nathan Chuck M. Lorica. Daniel Frank A. Magnaye. Zaira Krishna L. Maniego. Rhys Jeriel G. Morales. Caleb Marcus B. Romero. Calvin Nash M. Santos. Shehana Q. San Victores. Princess Joy D. Sena. Diana Yesha J. Silverio. Seth David E. Season. Nathan Chuck M. Lorica. Let us now proceed to grade 5 with honors. Zion Adley A. Alcantara. Mariel D. Buenavente, best in reading. Giancarl S. Buenaventura. Giancarl S. Buenaventura. Lara Isabel M. Concepcion, best in physical education. Neraya Jade I. Cruz, best in health. Josh Andre A. Bison. Sarah Abigail L. De Vera. Kendrick Samuel S. Latonero. Art Zeki L. Magzino. Lucilyn F. Naelga. Rian Paribi Pusing. Seth Gerard T. Recio. Charles Luigi G. Salazar. Samantha C. Santos, Best in Arts. Lordan J. Sumulong Jr. Let us proceed to the awarding, this time with high honors. Grade 1 with high honors. Ivo Nash G. Aguirre. Kim Abby B. Andaya, Best in GMRC Christian Living, Best in Arts, Model Pupil of Class 1 Love A. Safina Piel C. Gibaga. Gabe Jaron R. Jose. Solen Gabriel M. Mapua. Best in Araling Panlipunan, Best in Health, Model Pupil of Class 1 Peace. Mary Marta C. Marcoleta. Marcus Ezekiel R. Sangalang. Martina Isabel M. Torea. Samantha Chloe D. Velasco. Grade 2 with high honors. Epiphany Jeris A.S. Magsila, Best in Physical Education. Art Gabrielle Elise A. Asodicin, Best in Araling Panlipunan. Savannah M. Bartolay, Cian James William J. Chua, Best in Science. Liz Gabriel C. Cortez, Best in Filipino Mother Tongue, Best in GMRC Christian Living, Best in Music, Best in Health, Model Pupil to Sinai. Jamilia Rihanna F. Cruz, Model Pupil to Horeb Glass. Zab Isaiah M. Dipad. Miguel Alfred R. Domingo, Best in English, Best in Mathematics. Kylie Rain N. Inguito. Dominic Carl A. Magnaye. Dito pa lang po. Hindi pa tapos. We are having a technical difficulty. Please bear with us. Dominic Carl A. Magnaye. Atre Ujeg C. Patricio. Amia Chanel A. Piquero. Natalie Faith T. Suba. best in arts. Let us proceed to grade 3 with high honors. Briggs Andre G. Aguirre. Alistair Lucian D. Balingit, best in science, best in computer education, best in health. Andrea L. Benito. Rain Julian C. Cabunillas, best in English. Jemima Vijon I. Condes, best in Araling Panlipunan, best in music, Model 2PIL 3 NAL class. Aldrin Lucas H. De Leon. Vincent Matthew C. Durango. Jacob B. Lozada. Best in GMRC Christian Living. Aaron Jacob T. Maravillas. John Caleb L. Marcelo, best in Filipino. Isabelle Andrea D. L. Morales, best in Mathematics. Liana Luis D. L. Romualdo. Amara Lalaine D. Santos. Milena Pierin S. Santos. Shekinah Q. San Victor S. Model Pupil T. Jordan Class. Isabel Rose B. Terobias, best in arts. Gabriel C. Villafuerte, best in physical education. Juan Robert S. Villalobos. Mm-hmm. Let us proceed to grade 4 with high honors. Riley Inigo D. Cabuco, model pupil for Shalom class. Christina Jean De Leon. Stephen King M. Ella. Zachary Greg A. Nara. Vincent C. Taxagon. Grade 5 with honors. Shaila Catrice G. Bandong, best in GMRC Christian Living, best in Language, best in Science, best in Filipino, best in Araling Panlipunan, best in Computer Education, best in TLE, best in Music, model pupil, 5 Genesis class. Miguel B. Guanon, best in mathematics, model pupil, 5 Exodus class. Okay na. Let us now witness another special number by Natalie Faith T. Suba and Kylie Rain N. Ingito from grade 2 Sinai.
Thank you.
Thank you, Natalie and Kylie, for that wonderful song performance. Let us now continue for the presentation of awards with highest honors. Grade 1 with highest honors, Yuri Agaton S. Pascua, Best in English, Best in Science, Best in Mathematics, Best in Filipino, Best in Music, Best in Physical Education. Grade 4 with highest honors, Emmanuel John G. Discutido, Best in Language, Best in Reading, Best in Mathematics, Best in Science, Best in Music, Best in Physical Education, Best in Health. Sophia Agata S. Pascua, Best in GMRC Christian Living, Best in Filipino, Best in Araling Panlipunan, Best in TLE, Best in Computer Education, Best in Arts, Model Pupil for Agape Class. Children, your hard work, persistence, and determination truly paid off. Please give yourselves a round of applause. Congratulations. Okay, sige, i-introduce ko muna. Okay. Go na, Teacher Rose. All this will not be possible without the guidance and support of the parents, the patience that lies within the teacher's heart. Let us now hear Emmanuel John G. Discutido for his letter of gratitude.
A blessed, favored, and fulfilling day to all my classmates and schoolmates, our loving parents, the dynamic heads and members of our institution's Board of Trustees, our dear and hardworking principal, Ms. May Geraldine Ocampo, and the competent and respectable members of the faculty and everyone whom we consider a firm foundation. I am beyond grateful to have been given the privilege of you delivering a tribute of thanksgiving and gratitude during the TUMCSI Recognition Day 2021. According to a long-distance runner named Gabriel Grunwald, you can still make something beautiful and something powerful out of a really bad situation. The onset of the pandemic at some point had created an uncertainty in terms of the things that we must preoccupy ourselves with. All of the safety protocols like social distancing might have isolated us in terms of face-to-face interaction. But the revolutionizing power of technological advancement has paved a way for us to eventually cope up, no matter how it may seem new to us or something that we must gradually adjust to. In this situation, our premier Christian educational institution, the Taita United Methodist Christian School Incorporated, remained committed in upholding something that cannot be taken away from any one of us, and that is the universal value of education as a ticket for us to serve our nation soon enough. First and foremost, with humility and giving back to the divine reason of our success, I would like to thank God for He enabled us to have a committed and dedicated and persistent mindset whenever we do our academic tasks, one step at a time. In my personal perspective, and since majority of the tasks are hands-on, I somehow struggled during the first quarter, managing and finding a great balance in reviewing, editing video presentations, and artworks that must always be consistently great and appealing, and as such pave a way for me to never take education for granted, and always find ways to accomplish and to maximize my time in the comfort of our home. One step at a time, I redefined my body clock from something unproductive to something strict, planned, and goal-oriented in demonstrating my hunger to always learn day by day. I know and I am aware that some of us had different issues relating to internet connectivity or longing for physical contact and socialization with our classmates. But it is through our patient and ever-loving teachers who stood as our second parents that made all of our conferences lively and engaging. Therefore, I would like to thank all of our teachers who tirelessly worked just to finish all of our learning modules, the PowerPoint presentation that they need to flash whenever they are teaching on screen, and their commitment to always connect to us during our kamustahan sessions, so that our mental health as students, who have a tendency to burn out sometimes, will eventually be taken good care of. Similarly, I would like to especially mention our set of teachers that I have met and spent time with during synchronous conferences. First, thank you to our patient and understanding advisor from For Agape, Teacher Jun Rose Fernandez, since she will often motivate those who are class achievers each grading period to always give their best efforts and to thank God for being favored and fulfilled. Similarly, she never discredits the efforts of the honor students, but rather encourages them that they too can achieve the same thing with perseverance and dedication. I truly love her genuine personality in making our class light and always making sure that we will learn something that has moral to which we can apply in our everyday lives. Second, I would like to thank Teacher Filipina Magno, our former class advisor and our math teacher this year. She is constant in caring for the whole class and trying to give words of encouragement for us to discover our creativity, self-expression, and passion towards the arts, as well as enhancing our arithmetic and numerical knowledge in mathematics. Third, I would like to thank Teacher Mary Joy Marantal for raising our awareness towards sociopolitical and environmental issues in becoming responsible citizens through her subject Araling Panlipunan and Science. Fourth, I would like to thank our English teachers, Teacher Luisa Barzabal and Teacher Carla Marie Rosales, for enhancing our reading, grammar, and journalistic skills. As students, we must only share factual and verified information online. Fifth, I would like to thank our TLE and health teacher, Teacher Geraldine Manojado, for enhancing our productive home economic skills like sewing and recycling, as well as shedding light on our overall well-being and safety. Sixth, I would like to thank our computer and PE teacher, Teacher Sylvester Celis, for being light and energetic and teaching us how to be fit and be able to patronize our country's very own folk dances during our performance task and become knowledgeable in technology. Seventh, I would like to thank Teacher Zara Rubio, our Christian Living teacher, for emphasizing how to be righteous and Christ-like and be able to take care of God's creation. Last but definitely not the least, I would like to thank our music teacher, Sir Glem Zuniga, as he always brighten up our days with timeless songs and compositions that must always be appreciated. This truly shows that TUMCSI's school verse is truly reflected in the way their faculty treats and connects with their students, as what Proverbs 22 verse 6 says. Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. My gratitude and thanksgiving also extend to the unwavering support of our family, our parents, who will always cheer us up through our ups and downs, through our confusions and frustrations, and through our disappointments and proud moments. They're the main reason why we keep on moving, since all of their sacrifices deserve a gesture of giving back, to be able for them to experience relief and assurance that all of the money and sweat that they spend just to provide us with quality education and a conducive learning environment will never be wasted. Likewise, to all of my fellow classmates and schoolmates who are currently celebrating with flying colors, whether part of the honor roll or not, all of your efforts deserve to be appreciated since you remain passionate and strong and determined to be the source of hope for the youth. As we move up to another grade level, may our hunger for learning remain unchanged, but rather maximize every opportunity that is given to us. Let us continue praying for our nation and rest of the world to recover and be back to normal. But for now, and as what my opening quotation said, you can still make something beautiful and something powerful out for a really bad situation. Thank you and mabuhay tayo lahat, TUMCSI family, and may God bless us all.
Happy to let you know, you make me glow. I feel so good, it's true. So glad that I have you. Love me so, love all is right. I will wait, thank you for the glow, and thank you for the joy, thank you for the love you give to me. I'm glowing inside with your love, shining through. Thank you for everything you do. I'm glowing inside with your love. Remember my glory, there feel the joy because you're there for me. You cast the tears away. You wipe those tears. You gave me strength each day. I thank you for the grace, and thank you for the joy. Thank you for holding on here to me. I'm glowing, glowing inside the arena. Thank you for everything you need. I'm going inside the arena. You know, don't know me. My glowing like the sky, because of me, I saw the color. So I must thank you for your gift, and thank you for the joy. Thank you for your love you give to me. I'm glowing, glowing inside the joy. Thank you. Thank you for everything you do. I'm going inside because of
the sacrifices and love of your parents are truly beyond measure. They really work so hard and gave their best no matter how hard life is in this pandemic situation. There was a big change, especially with our system of education. But their willingness to learn so they can adapt to these changes is really admirable. They do deserve the award and recognition. Children, you may now put on your medals to your parents as a sign of your gratitude. Hats off to you, parents. You may now also greet your mother yesterday for the Mother's Day celebration. You may now put on the medals. Okay na. Okay na. At this point, let us hear Mrs. May Geraldine S. Ocampo, our beloved principal, for her closing remarks, followed by the prayer and benediction by Reverend Prudencio I. Peralta, our associate pastor.
Good morning, everyone. Can I be heard? Am I being heard? Yeah, give me a thumbs up. Good. Okay. Good morning. This year is very different. Different in so many ways. But God's faithfulness and love never changes. He's always in control. You just have to trust Him and believe. To our guest speaker, Dr. Diane Suleiman, thank you very much for a very inspiring message to all of us, the students, the parents, the teachers, and the school. This day recognizes the efforts of the school to make the online learning a success and something that really meets the needs of the students. Thank you, TUMCSI. Thank you, Board of Trustees. This day recognizes the efforts of the teachers and the staff to assist the children in their learning in the comfort of their homes. Your patience, understanding, having sleepless nights just to be able to finish the lessons for the coming days, all these will not go to waste. The learning of the children are the best results of all these things. And I salute you, teachers. Thank you very much and kudos to you. This day recognizes the efforts of the parents who have made a lot of adjustments, making both ends meet, trying their best to assist their children, and having the burden of helping out the kids with their activities, with their assignments, with their projects, which were, of course, usually done in school. Your efforts are not in vain, and they'll go a long, long way to provide your kids with lifelong learning. Congratulations, parents. And this day recognizes the efforts of the children who have finished the school year with flying colors. Your work and efforts bear much fruit. Remember that this is not for us, not for your teachers, not even for your parents, but for your future. Keep on moving, kids. Keep on thriving. Keep on reaching your dreams by doing your task, by being responsible, and most of all, by offering every talent you have to the Lord. Again, thank you very much. Thank you to all the teachers and the technical team for making this recognition very successful. And again, congratulations to all of you, to all of us. God bless us all and good morning.
Tayo pong lahat ay magpahayag ng ating pasasalamat sa ating Diyos. Sa pamamagitan po ng ating dalangin, mga bata. Samahan po ninyo ako. At din sa ating pong mga magulang, mga teachers and staff upang ipahayag ang ating kagalakan. Nararamdaman po natin ngayon. Tayo pong lahat ay dumulog sa ating Panginoon. Sige po. Kalihan sa lahat, maraming salamat po. Tunay nga na ang puso po namin ay nagagala sa oras na ito sapagkat minsan pa ay ipinahayag mo ang iyong pag-ibig sa amin, lalo-lalo na sa mga batang ito. Aming Ama, sa oras na ito, nais po namin ilapit sa inyo ang mga batang ito sapagkat sa kanilang pag-umpisa ng kanilang pag-aaral ay nariyan ka po na nagbigay ng protection sa kanila. Sa loob ng isang taon, Panginoon, ginabayan mo po sila. Patuloy kang nagbigay ng protection, provision sa lahat ng pangangailangan po ng mga batang ito. Iniligtas mo po kami sa anumang karamdaman, sa anumang kapahamakan. Kung kaya't narito po kami kasama ang mga batang ito, ang mga parents, ang ganun din ang mga teachers and staff na nagpapahayag ng aming pong kagalakan, ng aming pasasalamat. Salamat po, napakarami ng iyong mga plano pa, Panginoon, sa mga batang ito. Ikaw ang humawak ng buhay sa kanyang pag-aaral. Lagi kang magbigay ng wisdom, ng katalinuhan sa mga batang ito. Maraming salamat po. Patuloy ang aming panalangin para sa kanilang kalusugan. Lagi mo po itong bantayan. Aming Ama, ibinabalik po namin ang lahat ng papuri, lahat-lahat ng pasalamat sa iyong kabutihan po na ginawa sa buhay ng mga batang ito, ang aming mga teachers and staff, at ganun din higit sa lahat sa kanilang mga magulang. Pagpalain po ninyo sila sa pangalan ng aming Panginoong Hesus. Amen, amen, and amen. Congratulations po sa inyong mga anak, sa inyong mga bata. Pagpalain tayo ng ating Panginoon.
This has been a challenging speed for all of us. Teachers, parents, students, we made it. Congratulations once again. This has been Teacher Faye, your MC this morning. Thank you so much for your participation and for God with the glory. For some announcement, may we request everyone to please stay for our picture taking.
They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care, so call me crazy. We can live in a world that we
Next spring,
a million dreams. I think of what the world was filled.
One, two, three. Nasaan kami? Ayun. Ayun pala na. Huling-huling. Okay. Thank you everyone for joining us.